If you haven't heard the news, solar's dead! Well, what if I told you that was all a load of BS? Or, in the misquoted words of Mark Twain, the rumors of my demise have been greatly exaggerated. The panic is all because the federal solar tax credit expires at the end of 2025.
How about we all just try to keep calm?
In fact, solar panels will likely become a better financial investment in the years to come. Home solar isn't dying, it's evolving, fast. And my guests and I are gonna prove it to you on this episode of Plugged In. Make sure you're subscribed to Energy Sage's YouTube channel to stay plugged in to clean energy and other electrifying topics. So the Federal Solar Investment Tax Credit, or ITC, is gone for homeowners who want to buy solar panels after 2025. And listen, was all the hype to rush out to buy your system to get that incentive worth it?
The ones who really ended up losing this battle are the homeowners who won't be able to take advantage of the tax credit after this year, which is why we're advocating for people to go solar right now.
Yes. I have no regrets. But like any good comeback story, solar has found a new path forward, because what a lot of people don't realize is the tax credit isn't completely gone.
Now that TPO systems are the only ones that can qualify for the ITC after 2025, these savings would then theoretically be passed down to the homeowner.
That's Zoe Gaston, principal analyst at the consulting firm Wood Mackenzie, and she's talking about third-party ownership, or TPO. That's the industry term for solar leases and power purchase agreements called PPAs.
Everybody got that?
Now, with a lease, you pay a fixed monthly amount regardless of how much power your system produced that month, whereas with a PPA, you pay for the actual amount of electricity your system generated. Otherwise, rooftop solar leases work similar to car leases, and Zoe predicts they're about to become way more popular.
I do expect a market shift towards leases and PPAs. So for context, the third-party ownership share was about 56% in Q2 of 2025. And looking ahead at our forecast, I expect that to jump up to about 70% in 2026.
So what does TPO actually mean for you? With a lease or PPA, a solar company owns the solar equipment on your roof, but you get the benefits of the energy it produces. No major upfront cost, just immediate savings on your electricity bills. And because they own the system, they can also still claim the federal tax credit and pass those savings on to you through lower monthly payments. But let's talk numbers, because the choice between leasing and buying matters. Say you're looking at a solar panel system that would cost roughly $30,000 if you bought it outright. That's the average price in 2025, according to Energy Sage. Now, with a lease or PPA, you won't pay anything upfront, but you might have a monthly bill of about $200, usually starting lower and rising over time with annual increases. Those payments continue through the lease term, usually 20 to 25 years, which adds up to about $60,000 over time, or double what you'd pay to own your system. Now, I know, that might not sound worth it, but think about it this way. You'd otherwise pay nearly $87,000 in electric bills, so you're still saving about $27,000 over the course of your lease. Leasing also means no maintenance worries, and you're still using solar power, a win for the environment. Plus, you start saving on day one, while keeping money in your pockets for other investments or needs without tying up $30,000 in your roof. Financial advisor might even say you're better off putting that $30,000 in the S&P 500 for 25 years. It'd grow to about $200,000, assuming an 8% return. Now that I've sung the praises of TPO, let me quickly address the not-so-sunny side of solar leases. They have been quite suspect in the past, with complicated agreements and terms that were, let's say, unfriendly to consumers. They're also the bad actors promising free solar panels, only to screw people over with higher bills and interest rates. But things have changed. We now have some trustworthy leasing options. You just need to know where to look. And by the way, Energy Sage Advisors can help you with that. And as with any home improvement project, you need to read the fine print and understand the terms and conditions of your lease before you sign on the dotted line.
Peter, did you read the fine print on this loan contract?
And lastly, there's now a hybrid leasing option if owning your solar equipment is important to you. Zoe says there's this new rent-to-own model emerging that lets you, indirectly, take advantage of the federal tax credit, which could mean even better savings than buying your system outright.
They, you know, pass on the savings to the homeowner as a discount upfront. And then the homeowner, after a certain number of years, have the option to purchase the system and own it themselves.
It's kind of like leasing a car with the option to buy it later at a fair price. Now, whether you lease or own, you are still saving money. The biggest difference is whether you prefer lower upfront costs or greater long-term savings. Now, if the greater long-term savings through ownership does matter to you, let me show you why owning your system is still worth it without the tax credit. Because the saving potentials of solar, very much alive.
It's alive!
First up, solar panels are cheaper than they've ever been. Now, I know $30,000 $15,000 doesn't sound cheap, but it's about the cost of a used car. And 15 years ago, that same system would have cost you nearly $90,000.
Even without the ITC, a solar system could still be paid off in a decent amount of time.
Zoe tells me that losing the ITC adds about 2 years to the average payback period. Now, that number varies depending on where you live in the country, but here's what Wood Mackenzie's average two-year increase looks like with real numbers. Let's go back to that $30,000 solar energy system. If you installed it in 2025, paid upfront with cash, and were able to claim the 30% tax credit, you'd break even on your system in about 7 years with how much you'd save on electric bills. But in most cases, it's already too late to claim the ITC because of limited installer bandwidth through the end of the year. So if you install solar next year without the tax credit, you'd likely break even in about 9 years instead of 7. However, most solar panels come with 25-year warranties and often last 30 years or more, which means even with that longer payback, you still get 15 to 20 years of free electricity. Plus, you can also finance your system with a solar loan. Take it from climate activist Lauren Bash, who went solar earlier this year.
It was pretty crazy to see that the monthly payment we would have made for solar was about the same price as our electricity bill. So it would have just been like a bill swap. You know, we would have paid for that anyways in electricity. And then instead we paid for the solar panels.
Once you pay off your loan, your electricity is essentially free while your neighbors watch their bills climb higher and higher. Solar is truly only becoming more valuable as time goes on.
As the price of electricity just keeps going up and up and up, the economic equation for homeowners gets better and better.
That's environmental activist and author Bill McKibben. And it gets really interesting when we look at the 25-year picture. Right now, the average Energy Sage shopper pays about $2,400 per year for electricity. And that number is quickly rising, partially due to power-hungry AI data centers. And if you want more details on rising electricity prices, watch this episode. Going back to the stat we shared earlier, if you stick with the grid for the next 25 years, you'd spend nearly $87,000 on electric bills. But invest in a solar system today that's sized to fully cover your electric bills, and even without the tax credit, your total spend drops to the $30,000 that you paid for your panels.
So overall, it can still provide significant cost savings in the long term.
Significant savings, to the tune of $57,000 on average. And think about it, would you rather shell out money to power AI data centers or your own home? By 2051, the average American household is expected to spend about $4,700 a year on electricity, nearly twice what we pay today. Going solar is not only about immediate savings, it's about locking in a guaranteed price for electricity for years to come, protecting you from those crazy utility rate hikes, and protecting yourself from power outages, which have nearly tripled in severity since 2019. Take it from Martyna Kowalcyck of Solar Time USA. She says her Texas customers find that solar energy systems are far more valuable than any incentive.
Their first motivation is not the 30% tax credit. They call because they want resiliency, they want power in a power outage, and they want some alternative to being tied to a utility company.
Energy independence, electric bill savings, power security, lower carbon emissions, all these benefits don't disappear just because the federal tax credit is gone. Heck, Bill says he didn't even have the option to claim the ITC when he went solar.
I did it 25 years ago before there were incentives and back when it was really expensive. And I did it because my life's work is trying to head off as much of the climate crisis as we still can.
And he thought that 25 years ago. The climate crisis is only more dire now.
And I will say, I quite enjoy the feeling of being my own little utility.
I also haven't even mentioned that many states still offer their own rebates and incentives. Besides, while the ITC was a nice incentive for those who could claim it, many homeowners couldn't. Retirees with low or no tax liability, Americans who didn't owe enough in taxes to claim the full credit, and people who went solar with those leases and power purchase agreements we talked about, they couldn't directly claim the solar tax credit either. So all these reports of solar's demise, greatly exaggerated. In fact, these new solar financing options against the backdrop of rising utility rates only mean that the U.S. solar industry is becoming more innovative and accessible, and that's great news for homeowners. And if any part of you is sitting here thinking, maybe I'll just wait a few years and let solar prices drop, Bill would advise you otherwise.
I think it's like planting fruit trees. You know, the best time to do it was 20 years ago. And the next best time is today.
Every month you wait is another month of paying your utility company instead of investing in your own energy independence. So to wrap things up here, the federal tax credit was great to have, but it was never the reason that solar made sense. Saving money, saving energy, creating a more resilient home, contributing to cleaner air and water, these are and will continue to be so many smart reasons to go solar.
This still just makes bottom line sense in all kinds of ways, including not a small thing, that you're helping prevent the destruction of the planet that we happen to live on.
So here's what you should do. Get free quotes from trusted installers on Energy Sage to see the real savings that you can get from solar and battery storage. Their energy advisors can help you navigate state and local incentives and the many financing options to find what's right for you so you can stop paying absurd utility rates. Big thanks to Bill, Zoe, Martyna, and Lauren for sharing their insights on this episode. And tell me, are you still planning to go solar next year? And if not, what's holding you back? Drop a comment below and stay plugged in.